Hey, I'm John. I live in the middle of nowhere, and today we're going to make biochar. Well, just like anything else that you do, it's best to chop things up into small pieces. That's what's left from making charcoal in my barrel. Those pieces were just a little too big. In my last video, I made a barrel of charcoal. I've stored a bunch of it, but this charcoal here, I decided to make some biochar to go into my hoop house. If you don't already know, charcoal is just usually a hardwood, and you just bake it in an oven, basically, and then it becomes charcoal. You can crush the charcoal down into pretty small pieces, which would be pretty ideal for biochar because it gives you more surface area. People have been telling me to make biochar for years, and I didn't, and explained why. Is the soil here is natively high alkaline. I didn't want to just destroy my soil right out the gate. What we're gonna do today is I'm gonna hurry and test just the native soil for its pH balance. Then I'll test just the compost that I'm gonna use for its pH balance. And then we'll test a mixture with the charcoal in it. I'm not gonna put a ton in there, but we'll see exactly what our pH is. And well, it's just not that big a deal. We'll figure it out. So this is rainwater, and it's gonna be slightly acidic, and I'll show you. I have a pH tester here. We'll turn it on, and you can see it's calibrated at zero. And we'll give it a swirl here. We got 8.4. We're sitting about 7 now. So it turns out that the water is actually neutral, which is good. That's great. It seems like it used to be a little more acidic than that. But okay, so native soil, the reason that it's alkaline is because it's in areas that have low rainfall tend to have alkaline soil. I'll soak the soil here, and we'll test its pH level and see what a native soil's pH comes out to. I've got this hose here. This is connected to my rainwater system. It's the same water that's in the pond. Try to make this about 50-50. Just my guess. Just to get I think this will give me a decent pH. So it's just gone down a little bit. We're at 6.7. 6.6, which is towards a little more basic, but nothing extreme. This is a scoop of the compost that I've been making. It's not perfectly composted yet, but it's pretty good. This is good though. This is looking pretty good. It's at 6.7 right now. Which is a pretty decent pH to grow in, and that's with the biochar in it. Knowing what I know now, I could comfortably add all of this charcoal to that pile and add that much charcoal again in a little while. One wheelbarrow gave me enough to put about 2 inches down on top of everything. You might notice in my compost pile, I don't pull the tape off of the boxes. But out of that whole wheelbarrow, this is the only trash, and even this is actually wood. So just this little bit right here, and it's easy to get. It's just easier to grab it now and toss it. I imagine I could go ahead and plant some fall crops in here, and then I'll go do the same thing that I did here in the geothermal greenhouse. Because the temperature's regulated in here, I should probably be able to start some spring crops. These are all seeds that I grew and harvested myself. So I harvested those in 22, so fall, 21, 22. Anyway, Swiss chard, spaghetti squash, acorn squash, carrots. And I'm gonna go ahead and plant those out here because it's gonna still get pretty cold out here. It's the beginning of February right now. Okay guys, well, down one side I did carrots and Swiss chard, and down the other, spaghetti squash and acorn squash. Give it 30 minutes and we should have some stuff popping up. Hey, leave a comment if you got any questions. And you guys doing over there? Well, I'll catch you on the next video. What are they doing, Helgi? Are they being strange? Huh?